The informal meeting this morning was called for the purpose of improving the lines of communication among the Commissioner's Court and the County Auditor.
And what took place?
I believe as a result of this meeting this morning that the order for 6% pay raise as of July the 1st will be rescinded, and as a result, the lawsuit that is now pending will be nullified. Also, as a result of the meeting, I am confident that the employees will receive approximately, I would imagine, about a 4% increase in their salaries as of September 1st. I believe that this represents quite a great deal of give and take on both sides and should be welcomed by the county employees.
I assume then this is an acceptable compromise to you.
It is. In moments of a contest, one has to recognize that in a democracy, we have to give some and take some, and we don't always get our way. If we try to force our way, well, we result in not getting anything accomplished at all.
Now then, the public could surprise me by just riding the buses a whole lot more at the 30 cents, and I wouldn't have to do anything. I wouldn't have a deficit.
But it would take a lot of bus riding.
It certainly would, but we have the capacity and we have the system there for them. It's just a matter of whether or not they'd rather ride a little bit more or pay a little bit more when they do ride.
Are the prospects now, though, all things considered, that you will have to raise in the next couple coming months 5 or 10 cents on the bus fare, though?
Well, Teal, not necessarily. We will be required to make a decision, in my opinion, within the next 3 to 4 months as to which alternative to choose. We certainly will have to consider raising our fares. And after studying the fares in other cities, we do have some leeway. We're at 30 cents, and most of the major cities of over 500,000 population in the country already have 35 and 40 cent fares. So it would not be unusual to expect maybe a 35 cent fare in Dallas.
Hello, Yeloni. Hello, Yeloni. Mani wakwa. Mani wakwa. Ika yeloni. Ime ya mushi. Ime tusena me. Ime tusena me. Ime tusena me. Ime tusena me. Hello, Yeloni. Hello, Yeloni. Mani wakwa. Mani wakwa. Ika yeloni. Ime ya mushi. Ime tusena me. Ime tusena me. Ime tusena me. Ime tusena me.
Well, this is just a drop in the bucket of some 641 Dallas youngsters who have been enjoying themselves today on White Rock Lake. It's all part of the Pacific Athletic League program, and we have the director or president of PAL, who is Chief Bob Winter. Chief, what kind of day has this been?
Well, it's been a good one for us. These youngsters have had a good time. We've had a picnic, hot dogs, soft drinks, and so forth, athletic games, football, baseball, volleyball, about anything they've wanted to do.
And Paul Townsend, you are the Director of Community Services Division of the Police Department, and what prompts this kind of day?
This kind of day is brought about by a lot of hustling on the part of the officers assigned to our service centers. They get out and talk to up among these kids and told them what a good day they could have out here, and wanted to expose them to the Police Athletic League system, and this gave us a chance to get with them and make some real good friends.
Chief Winters, do you think these young people can leave here today with maybe a better feeling about the policemen?
Well, we hope so. It's been a sincere association with us, the officers. We've had about 20 policemen here off duty today, mm-hmm. involved in kind of guiding them and talking with them and meeting with them, and they get to see the human side of a policeman.
Now, I know they've had a helicopter out here today and vehicles and an F-8 Crusader from the Dallas Naval Air Station. Have they been pretty well allowed just to do as they please?
Well, we exposed them to it. They've heard nothing. The motorcycles, the freeway car here, it's got a different type of siren. And let them see it firsthand and close up. We prefer this.
William, what's your name?
Overton Lee Phillips.
Overton, after spending this day out here with these policemen, do you feel any better about the community and that these men are maybe trying to help?
A little better?
Well, I'll tell you what, isn't a little better than a little worse?
Yeah.
Overton, thank you very much. And we've been talking with Mr. Townsend, Mr. Winters of the Policemen's Athletic League. It has been a day for these youngsters, and just maybe they'll leave here today with a better understanding of their local policemen. This is Jim Mitchell, Channel 8 News on the Move at White Rock Lake. All right.